Alright guys, AirTags have been announced and I'm super excited, but this video is a little bit more serious. It is because Apple has brought this amazing product to market and people are going to know about it like never before. And you guys know I love my Bluetooth trackers, but they are designed for one thing: to find your misplaced items. Not people, not pets, nothing that is highly valuable or irreplaceable. So today's video is kind of like a PSA, a public service announcement, just letting you guys know my thoughts on using an Apple AirTag on a pet or on your kids or on something that is just not replaceable. So let me bring some friends out here really quick. Hi guys, this is Chloe and this is Bailey. She's like 13 and she's just a little over a year, so she's a puppy and she needs to go to bed, so I'm gonna go put her to bed. But Chloe and I will be right back. These guys mean the world to me. I would do anything for them. And I just think, you know, now that AirTags are coming and becoming very popular, a lot more people are gonna try different things, and I just don't think it's right to really put them on pets. So I understand that people wanna use these Bluetooth trackers on pets and kids, but the thing is, you really have to understand what a Bluetooth tracker is and how it works. In a nutshell, a Bluetooth tracker communicates over Bluetooth, meaning that it has to connect to another Bluetooth device to communicate out to the world. So it's doing this through your phone that has Bluetooth and a cellular chip that goes out to the world, and then it communicates with the servers and then goes to wherever it needs to go to. So if there is not a cell phone around that it can connect to, unfortunately that tracker cannot transmit any data whatsoever. In addition, a Bluetooth tracker does not have GPS. When it connects to your phone, it's actually using your GPS location of your phone, letting it know where it connected, and that's sending that data with the connection, with the GPS location. So you have to remember that, one, that it's Bluetooth, which has a very limited range, around 30 feet. If you're outdoors and you have line of sight, you probably get more. I've done some Bluetooth tracking distance tests, and yes, you do get more when there's no interference and you have line of sight. But the other thing to remember is that it only connects via Bluetooth to someone's phone. So if you want to use this on a pet, you just have to remember that this is not a GPS tracker and that the pet actually has to get within 30 feet of another iPhone user to transmit that location. Personally, I don't recommend Bluetooth trackers for pets. I think that most pets in most situations are gonna try to stay away from people. Yes, there are some great, some pets out there that are very friendly. They go up to anyone, but when a pet is lost, they actually get very nervous, they get scared, and they want to stay away from people. Plus, if you're in a rural or a suburban area, people are not around to begin with. So if you live out in the boonies, or if you're taking your pet for a walk in the woods and the pet gets off the leash, there's no one else around to transmit that data when it gets, when the pet gets lost. I can kind of understand if you live in the inner city and there's lots of people around. Yes, you might say my dogs will be within 30 feet of someone, but at the same time, if someone's there and they can see the dog or a bunch of people, they're going to stop the dog and look at the leash. They're going to see the dog tag and they can call you just as easy. So yes, it does have some advantages, but most of the time, you know, if you're not understanding that it's not a GPS tracker and you think that it is, there's no point in you buying it. If you think that it's like a dog tag, that's fine. I have no problem with that. Or if it's for an indoor pet, if you have an indoor cat or a dog that likes to hide, like she disappears all the time. That way you're able to ring it and you can find her. If, you know, if sometimes she's a little hard of hearing, she's getting a little old. So something with a ringer on it could definitely help you find her indoors. But for an outdoor pet, if you think it's gonna help you find a lost dog quickly and easily, it's it's just not made for that. There are devices that are designed specifically for pets and tracking lost pets, and they're pretty much just pet GPS trackers. And I actually have one here on Chloe. I recommend two different brands. This one is the Fi, and this thing has a great, great battery life. And the other one that I recommend is a Whistle, I think it's called the Whistle Go. Difference between a GPS tracker and a Bluetooth tracker is not only does this have a GPS chip built into it, but it also has its own cellular communication. So that way it can take the GPS location when, if she gets out of the house or, you know, gets outside the fence. That way I can go to the app, I can see the GPS location, and that data from the GPS location is sent over cellular into my phone. Without that cellular communication, there's no way to communicate that GPS location. Now you might be saying to me, these things are expensive, and yes, they are more expensive than Bluetooth trackers, and then there's a monthly service plan, or you can buy a discount rate if you buy the entire year. But these devices are designed specifically for pets and lost pets, so if that is what you're worried about, if you're worried about finding your pet quickly and easily and safely, then a GPS tracker like the Fi and the Whistle are the trackers that you want to look into. So now that we talked about pets, let's quickly talk about kids. The straightforward and blunt answer is do not use Bluetooth trackers on people. It's simple, it is straightforward, simply do not do it. If your kid is old enough, get them an iPhone or an Apple Watch with cellular. You can definitely track them that way through the Find My app, just as easy and more dependable. I'd rather you spend your time, your effort, and your hard-working money on watching your kids, spending time with your kids, making sure your kids are watched and taken care of, rather than depending upon some technology that's not designed for that mean. Appreciate you guys listening to me on my soapbox. I'm super excited for Apple Tags. They are going to be amazing. If you guys are excited as I am, let me know why down in the comments. Make sure you hit the subscribe button down below, and I'll see you guys on the next video. No, nothing can break me.